Can apostolics get depressed, and are we allowed to? Well, in today's video, I'm going to be addressing that question right there. And if that's something that interests you, continue watching. Hi, everyone. My name is Brother Mario. Welcome back to the channel. If you are brand new, the purpose of this channel is I'm here to show you that we are real apostolics with real problems, with real solutions, all solved in a divine way. And if this is something that vibes with you, consider subscribing to the channel. Hit bell notifications so you know exactly when I post a new video, every Monday and Thursday at 8 p.m. And finally, if you like this video, at the end of the video, well, hit the like button. I'd really appreciate it. Now, I know the question is very random, but are apostolics allowed to get depressed? Well, I wouldn't ask this question if I really didn't think there were people that doubted that question, that would actually answer the question that no, you're not allowed to be depressed as an apostolic. And before I answer the question, I want to first have you all consider my good servant Job in the Bible. Now, throughout the story of Job, we find him having a dialogue with three friends, and he's going in and out of depression and anger because, well, quite frankly, he lost everything. He lost his home, land, sons, daughters, wife. He lost everything. And so can we just admit to the fact that this man was probably depressed? Well, the answer is yes. This man absolutely was depressed. So we ask ourselves, are we as apostolics allowed to get depressed? And the answer again is yes, we are allowed to get depressed. But I say this with caution. I'm not saying go out there and go get depressed, right? No one wants to get there, right? When I was depressed at 22 years old, just dropped out of nursing, starting up an own business that failed 6-7 months later, I laid in my bed going in and out of crying and sleep for 3 days. And I can tell you now, I do not wish that upon my worst enemy to go through that. But I am so thankful that I did go through that because God was the only one that pulled me out. And so we have to understand something, that God has placed us here with these range of emotions. And there's a high probability that you and I are going to experience all these emotions, from the highest of highs of euphoria, right, the extreme end of happiness, to the extreme end of sadness, which is depression. But look how David pulled out of his own depression in Psalms 30:11. You have turned my mourning into joyful dancing. You have taken away my clothes of mourning and clothed me with joy. That's exactly what I went through when I went through depression. I went through my lowest of lows, and then God pulled me out. And I remember making a promise after I was pulled out by the mercies of Jesus Christ. I told myself I would never, ever allow myself to return back to that state again, because I know that God did take me there and he allowed me to get there. But I also know that he doesn't want me to go back. He has such a greater plan for you and I. But let's get back to the point here. I feel like that when it comes to depression, that us apostolics, we have to have this approval of men around us that we're okay, that we've got everything together because we have Jesus on our side. And just like those three friends that were criticizing Job in his mourning and his depression, accusing him of having some great underlying sin, I feel like we can do the same thing in us as apostolics, that either we have judged someone else or someone has judged us, and that bothers us to have this feeling that we don't have it all together and everyone else knows it. But I'm here to tell you that thank goodness we don't have it all together, because I know the one who can put it back all together, and his name is Jesus. We have to realize that as apostolics, that we are vulnerable. We don't have it all together. If we had it all together, do you know what? We would not need Jesus. Have you ever thought about that? If we had it all together, we would not need Jesus. And that's, again, where Jesus comes in. Jesus will take that depression out of your life. Don't feel guilty because you were depressed or have been depressed or are going through depression right now, because it is time for us to just look depression in the eye and say, you know what, Lord, I don't have it all together. I need you to take this one for me. I need you to take it all for me. And that's where Jesus comes in to rescue you from your own self. So we don't have to say that we have it all together. So the next time that brother and sister comes up to you and it's so clear on your face that you don't have it all together, that there's something seriously disturbing you, something in your spirit, or something that happened recently to you, it's okay to say I don't have it all together. It's okay to say that I'm not fine. But, and here's the key, make sure you answer and say, but I'm trusting in the one who can turn the situation for me, and his name is Jesus. And I know if I'm in his hands, everything's going to be okay. Because Romans 8:28 tells us this, and we know that God causes everything to work together for the good of those who love God and are called according to his purpose for them. I know when I was depressed that God put me in that situation for a reason, because his word also says he will never put enough on us that we can't handle. And if we just sit there and think about that, and we think upon the situations we've gone through just to get to this point, you can't just help and just praise God and be like, you know what, God, you're right. Everything that I've gone through, all the good times, all the bad times, the low valleys, the high peaks, everything that you've pulled me through has been because I've loved you, because I'm here to serve you. You knew I would serve you. You knew I would love you with all my heart. It just took some time for me to just experience that, for me to really turn my eyes and look at you and say, you know what, God, I can't do it on my own. I'm vulnerable. I can't do it without him. So I hope you all have responded. I hope you all are feeling this message of what I'm saying to you all, and just be rest assured that it's okay to not have it all together. If I had it all together, again, I wouldn't need Jesus, and neither would you. So thank you all for watching this video. I hope you are blessed. My name is Brother Mario. Peace.